Hello everyone. Well, we survived Transworld, and what an outstanding weekend it was. If you haven't already checked out my Transworld video, I'll have the link in the description below. I thought I'd start out this video by showing you what we came home with. I know Transworld isn't well known as a cash and carry trade show, but we certainly had no trouble in that department. This being our biggest purchase from Midnight Studio Effects, this little troll we named Tittimore was love at first sight for me. I'm not quite sure how I'm going to fit him into the haunt this year. He might have a scene all to his own, but either way, he's here to stay. I picked up these pumpkin hands from the Wolf Effects booth. I picked them up a couple years ago when I went, and I used them up on my trick-or-treaters. I like them because they're a smaller hand and the fingers are bendable. So I picked up like 6 pair of them. I'm sure I'll be using those up in the future. And from Demented Design Studios, I picked up this pie face for my Hansel and Gretel scene. From the Tandy Leather booth, I picked up Gel Antique, the Saddle Tan color. I know Alan Hopps uses this stuff all the time, so I plan on using this in future projects. I also got some Permablood. I always use the clear Elmer's glue and red food coloring, which works great, but it does wash off in the rain, so I was looking for something a little more permanent. From the Froggy's Fog booth, we picked up some new scents for our fog machines and a couple of the sprays. Like I got the gingerbread for our Hansel and Gretel scene, and the swampy marsh for our corn patch. So every scene in our haunt will have a different smell this year, so we're looking forward to that. I also picked up a Transworld sweatshirt, not to mention all the stickers and free stuff that you get from all the vendors. So we made quite a haul. So I'm anxious to show you what I've been working on since we got home. I know I've been on a prop kick these last couple videos, but I'm looking to get these finished and out of the way and on to new projects that I haven't worked on before. So I hope you enjoy this video. I hope I inspire, and I'll talk to you soon. So I thought I'd give you a little closer look at Tittimore and his little nose hairs and his mole hairs and his cute little horns and his sparse little hair on his head. Isn't he cute? I know. He's like only something a mother could love, I guess. But yeah, I hope you like him. I know if Pat had the nose hairs and the mole hairs, I'd probably disown him, but this is how warped I am. I've got my little Hansel and Gretel here, which is actually little Reg and Ryan and little Mental Marcia from Distortions. I was able to pick her up at Transworld this year at the Distortions booth. I pre-ordered her, and Reg and Ryan was purchased at Transworld a couple years ago. So these two are going to undergo major makeovers of their wardrobes. I've got a good friend that's real good at that sort of thing. So the next time you see these two, it'll be October. Okay, I pretty much have everything I need to complete my witch prop. I've got my 18-inch wooden base painted with flat exterior black top and bottom. I've got my half-inch flange that I'll screw in, and then this pipe screws into that, and my 1-inch PVC slides over that. I've got plenty of PVC joints and my PVC glue, pool noodles, padding, my poly satin for the finishing spray, my PVC cutter, plenty of burlap and black fabric, and creepy cloth. So I'm going to start with this female styrofoam head. I've been totally inspired by all you creative, talented haunters out there using this great stuff in all different kind of ways. I wanted a large witch head, so instead of using all paper clay, I'm gonna great stuff this styrofoam head, and then I've got a fresh batch of paper clay I made up. I'll sculpt with that afterwards. So I can't wait to get started. Let's head out to the garage. I've got the horns like cool hot glued in there so they stay in place. Plus the great stuff will lock them in also. So this is basically what I'm starting with, and I'm just going for like really heavy brows, big nose, big cheekbones. I'm just gonna hope for the best, and then I'm gonna have to just walk away because that's the way it is with great stuff. You just gotta do it and walk away. So, wish me luck. Okay, I am ready to sit down here and make the most of this, what looks like pretty much a bee's nest on a piece of PVC for now. But I promise, it will look better when I... Alright, I finished her up last night, horns and all. Had a little gravity problem overnight with her jaw, but Pat put this paint stick to hold it up till she dries, so... I've been wanting to paint him up. He's going to be the Joker from Batman. I'm going to do some face painting on him. I've already looked up some references on the internet, and I've got his outfit already. I'm going to clean him up. I've got a little beer garden tart going on. So this is the way I'm spending my Saturday afternoon, and I'll be back with an update. All right, I've got two good coats of my base coat. I'm ready to start dry brushing. My son tells me I need to go with the Heath Ledger version of the Joker, so that's the way I'm going. I've got my Hot Topic radio playing there, and I'm going to get into it.
Batteries to power, turbines to speed.
Roger, ready to move out.
This Joker here is ready to be put together. Pat made up some arms for me. He didn't have arms, so I'm going to put them all together, pad them up. His hands are all painted and sealed, as well as his toes. He's going barefoot, so it's just a matter of putting him together, and I'll be back when I'm finished. So I've got Joker Boy all finished here. I didn't distress his clothes because he's going to be hanging out with the girls in the boutique, so they are pretty clean cut, so I'm going to leave him as is. She's got three good coats of her base coat, as well as her hands. The moment is here. I'm ready for dry brushing.